शरीरा प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद अस्तुत्र सुकुमार भक्ति विराम मिश्र भवन श्री महाराज एवं शरीरा प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद अस्तुत्र सुकुमार भक्ति विराम मिश्र नारायण श्री महाराज गवेश अनंत बड़ी साष्टांग धन्यवाद ज्ञापन करता हूँ। तत्पश्चात नित्यलीला प्रविष्ट विष्णुपाद अस्तुत्र सुकुमार भक्ति विराम स्वामी महाराज श्रीलाम गोस्वी महाराज श्रीलाभक्ति श्रीधर गोस्वामी महाराज श्रीलाभक्तिगण भारती गोस्वामी महाराज एंड विशेष करके आज नित्यलीला अस्तुत सदमा भक्ति विराम तीर्थ गोस्वामी महाराज की सबंध में एवं उपस्थित सदियों की मेरा सागर आज प्रातःकाल से हम लोग
Since morning we are hearing the transcendental life history of Srila Bhakti Vedanta Tirtha Maharaj from the different Vaishnavas. When we have the teeth, we do not understand the glories of the teeth. But when we lose our teeth, then we understand the glories of the teeth. If we do not clean the teeth, then our teeth would be damaged, cavities would come, and at that time it is so much pain in the teeth. And in the night, if 12 you get pain in your teeth, then what will you do? You will not get the dentist in the night. So in the morning you will go to the doctor in the, so you will have to bear the pain for the whole night. So when we have one particular object, we do not understand the importance. When it is in between us, the Guru Vaishnavas are with us, then we do not understand their glories. Then we look at their external faults and we keep on criticizing them and keep on doing offenses. So that is why it is said the Vaishnava's charitra is sadai pravitra. Lakshman, bahar hai koi. So Vaishnava's character is always pious. But we see the faults. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says the one who criticizes this kind of Vaishnavas, I always stay away from that person. Vaishnava's character is always pious. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that I always stay away from those people who criticize the Vaishnavas. But when we will be able to understand the glories of the Vaishnavas, when we go to the materialistic world, and when we feel deficiency of the Vaishnavas in our life, that I have got such a great wealth and I have now lost that wealth. Guru Vaishnavas being merciful, they give us the association. But we are unable to get the benefit of association. Bhagwan mercifully gives us the association of the Guru and the Vaishnavas, but we are unable to get that benefit of association. But when they leave this world, then we understand, oh, what we have got the and what we have now lost, such a wealthy thing. when Srila Maharaj was present in this world, his transcendental services we could not understand. That how he used to be always engaged in the Guru Seva, Guru Nishtha. He was Ek Nishtha Guru Sevak. From the very starting, we used to stay together in Keshavji Gaudiya Math. For the 1 year we stayed at Navadvip. Then after 1 year, Narayan Goswami Maharaj mercifully brought us to Mathura. Then we stayed in Mathura all together. And we have seen their nishtha towards Gurudev, Vishrambhena Guru Seva. One is Sambhram, one is Vishrambha. Sambhram means that always having this thought that I should not do the offenses to the Gurudev, even if he is giving one water of glass to the Gurudev, his hand is shaking that am I not doing any offense? So this is called Sambhrama Seva. That always having this fear of offense and Vishrambhena Guru Seva. And what is that? Adu Gudupad Ashraya Shiksha Diksha Guru Vishrambhena Guru Seva. Vishrambhena means Shram Rahita. Without means considering the Gurudev as Nijajan, that he is my own. Just like the parents, how they serve their children with mamata, with sambandha and mamata. So the service that is having these two qualities, mamata and sambandha, which doesn't have any fear, is called Vishrambhena Seva. Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada writes, Vishrambha Seva is the Antaranga Seva. Vishrambha Seva's other name is Antaranga Seva. When we have the fear in service, when we think that he is senior to me, and I am so small, then we always have the fear that we always have this doubt that I may do some offense while doing service. But when we have this feeling that he is my close family member and I have this mamata, a concentrated mamata. So in seva there are two things, mamata and sambandha. And that sambandha is without any aishwarya, just like laukik sambandhuvat, just like the ordinary relationships. So Vishrambhena Guru Seva means having no Aishwarya Bhav. Like the Brajavasis, they serve Krishna. The gopis, they give so much nice type of pakodas, the food, sweets to Krishna. So this is the mamata. Because of the mamata, they are giving so many things to the Krishna and considering very close family members. That is called Vishrambhena Guru Seva.
Vishrambhena Guru Seva. हम इससे करें तीर्थ महाराज के साथ हम देखा
तीर्थ महाराज फॉर तीर्थ महाराज वी हैव सीन
किस प्रकार की सेवा आदि करते थे
दैट हाउ ही यूज्ड टू सर्व श्रील गुरुदेव
जरूर है जरूरत होते तो गुरुदेव जी लड़ भी लेते थे
इवन ही यूज्ड टू फाइट तो व्हेन देयर इज अ नीड टू फाइट विद द गुरुदेव
आपको के गुरुदेव के साथ लड़ना तो अपराध हो जाएगा
सो वन मे से दैट इट इज एन ऑफेंस टू फाइट विद गुरुदेव Because when we are doing the Vishrambhen Guru Seva at that time, if there is a need to fight with Gurudev, even the disciple would fight. That is called service.
निकटतम है तो अनेक जी से गुरुदेव के सन्निकट में आते हैं तो उनके उनके प्रति अधिक घनत्व होता है माने अंतरंग सत्ता होता है उसी प्रकार हम देखा
So we saw that Srila Tirtha Maharaj, his name was Shubhananda Brahmachari. When I saw first and I saw that he was so open to Gurudev. And I used to think in my mind that how can he be so open to Gurudev? Then I understood slowly that it is because of the mamata. Just like Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj with the Prabhupada, he was having such a great mamatva. With a great mamatva he used to serve
Prabhupada.
So Prabhupada used to call everyone Aap, but for the Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada used to call him Tum, Tu. Why? This is called Vishrambha Seva, with the Vishrambha Seva to control the heart of the Guru. If I ask you, oh, come here, then you will feel bad because you will say that I am so educated, why you are speaking to me like this? Not with respect, I am so educated. Maybe you do not speak in front of us, but after us, that person will surely speak against. Because we think that I am so educated, why Maharaj speaks with me without respect in front of everyone? But when we have love, when we have the mamata love, then we never see any fault. We see the fault when we are unable to analyze our own faults. Srila Prabhupada says that when we see the faults of others, when we are unable to see our own faults, and then we will see the faults of others. But when one starts looking at his own faults, then he never will be able to see the faults of others. So that is why it is said that do not look at the faults of others. Always look at the faults of yourself and try to correct yourself. So this is the actual thought. So when some sadhak, he comes in this stage of looking at his own faults, then he will surely achieve this Vishrambhen Guru Seva. Just like your father, he never calls you Aap, he says Tu. This is called Laukik Sadbandhu Vat Bhav. And this was a special quality of the Tirtha Maharaj, that he was having such a great mamata. And he was also having the mamata towards everyone. And when there is a need, he used to scold with the stick, beat with the stick also. But when there is a need, he used to smile. In the Navdvip Parikrama, when all the yatris, they were sitting and the khichdi has arrived, and at the time, at Godru,
ठाकुर जी चैतन्य मठ के सामने जो है जहाँ पर भक्ति भवन के वहीं पर प्रसाद
स्कूल भक्ति भक्ति विनोद इंस्टीट्यूट भक्ति विनोद इंस्टीट्यूट
देखो 34 लोग सब बैठे हुए हैं।
So in the Bhakti Vinod Institute in the Navadvip, everyone was sitting and all the Yatris were sitting and the Brahmacharis were standing and they are not doing the service. And Tirth Maharaj, he used to have his stick and used to beat everyone. But why you are not serving? And then after some time, after scolding those Brahmacharis, he used to call that Brahmachari and give him the prasad himself. हमारा भी उतना नहीं हुआ पर देखा है। So he was having such a great love towards the brahmacharis also, just like a child in one moment he becomes angry, and in another moment the child starts laughing. Tirth Maharaj was also same. I said in the morning also that in the Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita there are 26 qualities of the Vaishnavas explained. All these 26 qualities were visible in Tirth Maharaj. If I start speaking all these qualities one by one, it will take so long time. But all the qualities were present in him. If any yatri would come from Bengal, they used to come in the night, one or two, because the trains are late or for other reasons they used to come late in the night. And in the night, 1 o'clock, 150-200 yatris have come from Bengal. And they have not eaten anything, they are hungry. So I have seen with my eyes that at 11:30 and 12, he used to go in the kitchen and cook for them. He again cooked rice, dal and one sabji for all the yatris and gave it to all the yatris. And what we will do, we will say that we will see in the morning. But no, he used to cook in the night. He was having the mamata priti towards everyone. Once I was talking to someone that why the Bengalis, they respect Tirth Maharaj so much. Because of the service, you can control anyone, you can attract anyone. He himself used to cook and he used to give it to everyone, all the yatris. And there was never laziness in him. He was always without any kind of laziness, always engaged in service and always writing the grantha. In the morning also I said that in the night he used to get up 1 o'clock and used to write. Until 3 o'clock he used to write for 2 hours. Then 3:30, 4 he used to take bath and used to come in the Mangalarti, and don't know when he used to sleep. The Bhagavat that he has published in Hindi, Srimad Bhagavatam, पांच खंड
और आगे जो उन्होंने जो किया गुरुदेव के
तो अलग है। पांच खंड हुए हैं इनके भागवतम के। सो ऑल दिस भागवतम हैज बीन रिटन बाय हिम
और प्रवचन पाठ प्रवचन हरि कथा
पाठ प्रवचन हरि कथा ही वाज हैविंग सो मच इंटरेस्ट। द वन हु हैज द इंटरेस्ट इन वन पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट ही कैन नॉट स्टॉप हिमसेल्फ फ्रॉम डूइंग दैट। गुरुदेव यूज्ड टू से वन थिंग दैट इफ आई डू नॉट स्पीक हरि कथा आई फील हेडेक। And when the Harikatha is happened, then all the headache is gone. वन टाइम इन द जन्माष्टमी एट द टाइम ऑफ जन्माष्टमी
उस समय वो क्या बोले राजमार्ग एक बार उसको आज क्या बोले वो एक बना में फलाहार बनता
है सो एट 12 वी कुक द फलाहार
और श्री गुरुदेव बोले तीर्थ महाराज जी क्या उसको बोला
श्री गुरुदेव कॉल तीर्थ महाराज And he was having the gamcha, wearing the gamcha, and he came and he started speaking in front of the Gurudev. Gurudev asked him to do katha. So there was the oil on the gamcha, and the other things were there on his clothes. But he started speaking the katha. There is no need for the preparation. Just give the mic in his hand. That's enough. Any topic, any subject, there is no need for preparation for him. There is no need for him to write anything. What to say, what not to say. So naturally, he used to speak. He was having such a great interest in Harikatha. Yeah? So there were like 50-60 people in the Brajmandal Parikrama in the early days. There were like couple of buses. At that time the Rupsanath Math was not there and Giriraj Govardhan Math was also not present from the Mathura. We used to hire one bus, two buses. And we used to do all the parikrama. And he used to carry the luggage of all the passengers and lift it on the roof of the bus. And he was not having the pride of being such a great pandit. Even the pandits of the Mathura, the great pandits of the Mathura used to praise his katha, Manoharlal Shastri, Vasudev Chaturvedi. So these pandits of the Mathura, they were the great pandits of the Mathura, they used to praise Tirth Maharaj katha. They used to praise in front of the Gurudev about Tirth Maharaj's katha. So one may read Bhagavatam if one doesn't have the knowledge of the Sanskrit. One cannot read the commentary of the Bhagavatam because the Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur's Tika is in commentary in Sanskrit. Shridhar Goswami Pad, Jeev Goswami Pad, everyone's commentary is in Sanskrit, so Sanskrit knowledge is required. Because in the commentary is complete Sanskrit. Everyone can read the Bhagavatam Shlokas, but if you read the Tika, the commentary, because in the commentary the full shloka is not given, half line, half shloka is given, and then the karak and the vibhakti, and what would be the meaning using that vibhakti and the karak, and there are so many permutation combinations which shloka to be used where. Like in Brahma Stuti, the second shloka of the Brahma Stuti, in the Govatsa Harana Dila, when Brahmaji did Stuti for Krishna, Vishnu Chakravarti Thapad says in the commentary, he is explaining using the shloka of Brahma Sanhita. अंगानि यस्य सकलेन्द्रिय वृत्तिमन्ति
पसन्ति पान्ति इस श्लोक के कारण अंगानि यस्य सकलेन्द्रिय वृत्तिमन्ति वो श्लोक दिया अंगानि यस्य सकलेन्द्रिय कितना श्लोक दे दिया इस श्लोक के ऊपर विश्वनाथ चतुर्थी पाठ कर रहे हैं।
On this श्लोक विश्वनाथ चतुर्थी पाठ says
केवल कृष्ण
that this श्लोक is
कृष्ण और कृष्ण के कौन अवतार अग्नि मजिद जो है
only can be used for Krishna and his incarnations।
अर्थात भगवान किसी अंग के द्वारा
that भगवान from any body part he can do activity of any other body part from the eyes he can see from the eyes he can eat and walk।
ये जो श्लोक जो है
This श्लोक is applicable on Brajendranandan and Shyam Sundar and all his avatar incarnations. But whether it is present in the Parikar or not, in the Tika it is said that it is not in the Parikar, in the associates, it is not in the associates of Krishna. But if we do not read this Tika, because where which word has to be used, like the na, the word na, if it would be used at a wrong place, then we will take the wrong meaning. So one should have the knowledge of Sanskrit. The one who doesn't have the complete knowledge of the Sanskrit, then you cannot read this commentary. That is why the Advaitavadis even from the Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur's Tika they will prove that it is everything is Brahma because if you do not know the Sanskrit they will make you a fool but if you have the knowledge on the Sanskrit then you will be able to refute that no this word should be used in this sense the word ma the word na where they should be used properly so Tirtha Maharaj was so perfect in all tattva siddhanta We used to read their commentary of भक्ति रसाम सिंधु भागवतम उज्ज्वल नीलमणि
पूरा जो है हम लोग
And when we are unable to understand the meaning properly, then we used to go to Srila Gurudev and we used to get the solution from the Gurudev. So he was having the complete knowledge about the Sanskrit, he was Pandit. I came in the 81. When I came in the 81 in the Devanand Gaudiya Math, I saw that he was speaking in Sanskrit. And I was so impressed and I got this desire. I asked my uncle that how can this Brahmachari speak in Sanskrit? Who is he? Then my uncle said that he is the Brahmachari from Mathura. At that time, everyone used to get impressed with the names of the Mathura Brahmacharis. Because whenever we used to go anywhere, they used to say that, oh, you have come from Mathura, from Narayan Maharaj. My Gurudev Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj was full of humbleness. Once I remember, we did not get much association of Vaman Goswami Maharaj. Our Gurudev, he used to always be in preaching. I could not get the physical association of Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, though I stayed in Navadvip for 1 year because he used to go for the preaching always. At the time of Navadvip Parikrama, he used to come. And he used to come also in the disappearance day of Param Guru Maharaj. For the rest of the time, he used to be in the preaching only. When at the time of Navadvip Parikrama, he used to go there. Gurudev used to ask, tell us that you are all Brajvasis. Gurudev used to say that Gurudev speaks some katha. Then Gurudev used to say, you all are Brajvasis, you speak some katha in front of me. So he was personified humbleness. Have you seen Vaishnav Maharaj? Sanyasi Maharaj, Acharya Maharaj, Prajanya Maharaj, all these sannyasis. They all used to respect those who used to stay near Narayan Goswami Maharaj, because Gurudev's teachings, Tattva Siddhanta, was so perfect, and they used to say that the disciples of Narayan Maharaj cannot speak anything against Siddhanta, and his Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj Gurudev's influence was of such level. He used to go in the Natya Mandir. Everyone used to be present in the katha, and if someone would not come, then he used to call them. He even used to call the Prajanya Maharaj. He used to call my uncle also, Krishna Kripa, come here and hear the katha. Maharaj Gurudev used to say that do other activities later, but come in the katha right now. So he was having such a great influencer. Tirtha Maharaj, when he used to speak katha full of bhav. Once Tirtha Maharaj, on the Dwadashi day, when we go to the Mam Kachi, and there is a Khichdi Prasad in the Mam Kachi. But due to some reason, the afternoon prasad did not take place, and in the afternoon it was in the mud the prasad took place, and it was so hot, and that the road was so hot, and all the passengers, jatris, they came back, and it's been 2 in the noon. All the brahmacharis were also tired. Then our chachaji said that no brahmachari is ready to do distribution. Then at that time, Srila Gurudev, Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj said that go and ask Narayan Maharaj. Gurudev Narayan, Vaman Goswami Maharaj never used to scold anyone, because he has given all the responsibility to the Narayan Maharaj to scold the brahmacharis. All the control was under the hand of Narayan Goswami Maharaj. That is why Narayan Goswami Maharaj, at that time Narayan Maharaj never used to give diksha. Narayan Guru Maharaj used to say that your Gurudev, he gives birth to the children, and I have to clean their toilet. Means Vaman Goswami Maharaj, he used to make the disciples, and all the anarthas would be purified by Gurudev. And our Chachaji, Krishna Kripa Prabhu, that time the Narayan Maharaj was taking rest and Shubhananda Prabhu was standing nearby and said, Shubhananda, no brahmachari is here to serve. Everyone is sitting here and there and it is so hot outside and no one is serving the prasad, distributing the prasad. The Shubhananda Brahmachari, what he did? Where the brahmachari was sitting prasadam, then he shouted that Srila Gurudev Narayan Gosai Maharaj is coming. As soon as he announced that Narayan Maharaj is coming and all the brahmacharis, they left their patal and they're running, because if the Narayan Maharaj would come, then he is surely going to beat us. Then all the brahmacharis running. I saw and even the couple of brahmacharis, their feet got burned because of the hot rice. Their feet put on the hot rice. Gurudev was so sweet in speaking. I know that you have done such a great hard work going to so many houses for the bhiksha. Today also is the day you should do the service. So some more service you should all do, some more hard work you should all do. By hearing these sweet words from the Gurudev, everyone started distributing, and in the 1 second all the distribution took place. So this was the influence of the Gurudev. Tirth Maharaj himself, he used to do the service. Who is going to take the responsibility of Tirth Maharaj now? His Udar Charitra, his service. Even if someone doesn't have the money, he used to get everyone along with. So like the responsibility was given to different people to check the tickets, but when Tirth Maharaj used to come, he never used to check any tickets, and even if he has given the responsibility to someone, he used to scold that person even. So if someone would come to Maharaj that I do not have the ticket, I do not have the money, Maharaj used to say that what is the need of ticket? There is no need for the ticket, go in the bus. Wherever there is a seat vacant, you go there and sit, no problem. So he used to allow everyone, and even he used to say on the mic that wherever the seats are vacant, you go and take the seats. So this is the open-mindedness. Because the Krishna is giving. If you have not given, then others are giving. If someone is giving 100 rupees and someone is giving 1000 rupees. If your ticket's money is 200 rupees and you do not have 200 rupees to give, but other has given the 1000 rupees. So he never used to count. He used to say that he has come for the Brajmandal Parikrama. Then why asking money from them? Other has given the money. There may be some people who doesn't have the money, and some people they used to make them get down from the bus. But Tirth Maharaj, he used to scold that person that why you are getting him down.
अरे इतने दूर से दिल्ली से इधर से जब आए 200 रुपया क्या वो नहीं देंगे अरे कहीं किसी को पनामी तो देख करके जाए
So it is fine if they do not give the money, at least they will be giving some kind of pranami, or because there is no one who doesn't give anything. Everyone will surely give something. Because the Grihastha Vaishnav, they never go for free because they always give money. So why you are asking? Because they also give pranamis. So they have come for Brajmandal Parikrama, do not stop them. So how open-minded he was. So he was having so much generous nature. One should not be miser. One should always be generous. We will surely be feeling the deficiency of Tirth Maharaj in Brajmandal Parikrama and Navdeep Parikrama. We all will be realizing his absence, because a person like him is very difficult to find. Because he always used to take care of which bus has come or not. Because we used to come in our buses, but Tirth Maharaj used to take responsibility of all buses. Even if some yatri is not feeling well, he himself used to give them the medicines. He himself used to reach the place where he used to stay. His room was always open even in the night. And he used to give the medicine to all the yatris wherever they are staying. That is why our Brajmandal Parikrama was going on so nicely. Because he used to make all the arrangements. Pradyumna Maharaj, he used to send the prasad. So he used to always take care that at what time the prasad is going to come. Sometimes the prasad used to go at some other places. In the last parikrama also, some buses they went somewhere else and the prasad was supposed to happen at Pankha. But then Tirth Maharaj, he scolded everyone that why you sent the buses on that direction. So he used to take care of so many things. Even about charging of the mic, he used to take care. Many times after the Pravachan, no one cares about the mic, that where the mic is. Tirth Maharaj himself used to carry the mic. Though he used to distribute the responsibilities to everyone, but he himself still used to take care of all those responsibilities. And he used to take care of charging of the mic, and he used to keep the mic in his own room. Gopinath Bhavan mein rehte the na? So he himself used to take care of the mic charging. The one who takes the responsibility. The responsibility has to be taken by oneself. It is not that you can put it on others. If one has the hat, then there must be a headache. If one doesn't have head, then how he will feel the headache? Means the one who has the responsibility, then he will surely have the pain of that responsibility also.
और विशेष करके बोले देखो ये कैसे उन्होंने अपराण में दल निकला के कैसे भी उन्होंने तात्पर्य क्या है
The pure Vaishnava, when they leave their body, there must be, there is always a reason that Tirth Maharaj, he left his body in the Aprahan Leela. Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj entered in the Nishant, in the Sandhya Leela. Srila Gurudev Narayan Goswami Maharaj, he entered in the Nishant Leela. तीर्थ महाराज व्हेन ही एंटर्ड इन द अपराहन लीला व्हेन द कृष्ण इज कमिंग बैक फ्रॉम द गोचारण एंड ऑल द गोपीज आर वेटिंग फॉर कृष्ण दर्शन व्हेन अ प्योर वैष्णव लीव्स द बॉडी They enter into the Leela, there is always a reason behind it, at what time, what Leela they are going to enter. There is a essay of the Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur also on this topic.
Hare Krishna,